right, I'm going to do a little demonstration here of our, with a plasma ball inside of this test enclosure. And the enclosure has a platform underneath that's able to rotate.
This is the plasma globe we have mounted to a motor.
So what we're going to do is have this plasma ball rotate at reasonably high speeds, 2 to 3,000 RPM, we hope to be able to get out of it. And we want to observe what's happening inside the plasma ball during that time and see if there's any unusual things that take place due to the centrifugal force being exerted on it. So I guess that's about it. Using this TQI controller, which is normally used on little race cars, and we'll be controlling the RPMs of the motor. This is a Subaru blower motor underneath here, powering the apparatus. Okay, let's fire it up and see what happens.
Lights off.
Lights off and...
safety glasses on.
Safety glasses on. My safety glasses are all fogged up. I can hardly see a thing. See if we have some action here. There we go. Okay, it goes around. We know it goes around. So far, so good. It's nice and smooth. So, we'll take it up to maybe 500 RPM, something like that. Okay, I'll just stop it and we'll see what happens. Motor stopped. And you can see the plasma keeps rotating for a revolution or two. Where it settles down. Let's try taking it up to maybe about 1500, see what happens. That's actually 1600 there now. Seems stable. I'm going to take it up to 2000.
Oh, look at that.
There's 2000. Interesting structure in there, that's for sure. Let's bring it down again and see what happens. And rotates a bit, and otherwise seems to look pretty much normal,
yeah,
I guess.
Pretty much the same.
Okay, so, just gonna... pardon me?
Full speed!
Full speed ahead! Let's give it a go while the apparatus is still working.
In one piece.
Yeah. Okay, I'll just give it full speed and it's going to make sure everything's still screwed together properly here.
Maybe hold it because it starts walking a little bit on the table.
Yeah, we should have it bolted down as Mr. Keshe says because it could take off once we achieve levity, and that's what we're after here is levity, which we know is the cure to gravity. Actually, you should have this whole thing on a scale because then we'd be able to tell if there's any weight changes. Okay, we're going to go for full speed. Here we go. 1,000, 13, 15, 17, 2,000, 22, 23, 24, 26, 30, 37, 37, 6, 37, 80, 39, 39, 41. Well, pulling together pretty good. I'm not sure what the plasma is doing. I've been watching the tachometer. We're around 4,000 RPM. Nice and stable. Everything is moving around the entire table. But apparatus has got its own mind as far as where it wants to go. Well, we got a thing go.
Especially the beam that goes up, man.
Yeah, the one that goes right up in the middle, it's very determined to stay there. It doesn't hardly quaver. There's almost a harmonic in there.
A pulse, yeah.
Hey?
Like a pulse.
A pulse, like, yeah. This looks like wings, almost like a dragonfly from my point of view here. And as we come come to a close, the plasma rotates another couple of turns before it settles out and wonders, what the heck just happened? Hey there, little fella, it's okay now, you made it. Good for you.
The other
so
way
did
around.
We, even better.
You now have to spin them the other way around for the same amount of time to make them move.
Well, actually, I can make them go backwards and then forwards suddenly.
Oh, yeah? Oh, sweet. You're abusing it.
That's abusing it, probably, yeah. It's abusing everything, that.
Now, the one that goes to the top, that's really something that must be, I don't know, must be a reason for that. It disappears as soon as
well, it. Yes, that's a good observation. Okay, how would I explain this? The way it is right now, the streamers are running all over. There's not really one that goes to the top. But when I rev it up, there's... Right now there isn't, but as soon as the revs get up a little bit, there becomes essentially one streamer at the top. The faster it goes, I'd say the more intense it gets, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's
definitely
quite intense right now. That's interesting.
It's like less go to the side and more go upwards now, because it's the most stable route, I guess, to the outside. Everything else is moving, but upwards.
Right. That's right. In the center of the cyclone, doesn't move. Right?
Yeah, basically.
So it
yeah.
might be the path of least resistance for the
yeah, it is, yeah.
for the ions to flow.
The other ones are have to spin around. So. That's quite funny.
Interesting. I wonder what it would look like if hydrogen and helium were in there, along with the argon and neon and any other ions that are in there. All right, well that was definitely a successful experiment. Okay, I'm just gonna do a quick run here of the close-up of the plasma ball and see what kind of changes occur. I want people to pay attention to the central tendril that'll come up to the very top of the globe. Let's rev it up and see how it goes here. You can see the central tendril is forming there now. It's already formed. At about 1,000 or so RPM, which forms that central tendril. I'm going to rev it up. Jesus. I wonder what happens when whole thing is tilted over a bit. Here, you run the throttle, and I'll just tilt this over. I want to see if that tendril stays the way it goes.
Top.
Well, there's definite geometric shapes at certain RPMs. With the arms that come off the the tendrils that come off that center post, they're like little ballerinas in there doing different moves, you know, do the rotating dance. Scary. Here, you hold the apparatus and I'll run the throttle control now. Okay.
Like, once the upper one is formed, it's only disappearing at lower RPMs, then it takes more RPM to create it than once
and
it's there.
To destroy it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, right. Interesting.
But it's quite logical, actually. I mean, everything we saw is quite...
Well,
yeah.
I would have never guessed, though, that those tendrils would have momentum. You know, the fact that they keep momentum,
mm-hmm.
that's what surprised me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, true. Okay, we have the plasma ball, plasma globe ball inside of our rotating apparatus here with the safety shield on and the safety glasses on. And we're going to have a look at the streamer coming off the plasma ball. We have a piece of tin foil sitting up against the globe of the plasma ball inside there, and it's acting as a sort of a ground that's attracting the tendrils of the plasma ball. And we're going to rotate it at speed and see what happens to the tendrils as the plasma globe rotates. Okay, here we go. Now the tendril has tended to sort of warp to one side of the the way it's rotating. And as we rev it up a little more, we're up to about 1,000 RPM. And at one certain point, right about now, the tendril from the center of the globe goes straight up to the top of the globe. And there's no other tendrils in there, and that becomes similar, maybe even a little more intense with high speed. We'll take it up to 2500, for example, and it's still one tendril. Take it up to full speed.
Something going on.
Okay, let's note this phenomenon that we've also noticed here, which is the central tendril that goes up to the top right now, as we lower the RPM, it'll tend to stay there much more stably. It's easier to keep it going than it is to get it going to start with, you might say. In other words, I can lower the RPM or right down to a few hundred RPM here now, and the central tendril stays there right until probably about, well, it's still there, strangely enough. And now it's sort of there. It's locked onto the tinfoil to the side. Now, but to break that, I have to rev it up. Now it's still stuck to the side. Still stuck to the side. I have to take it up to about 1,000 RPM. To get the thing to go into the top tendril. There it goes. So again, we'll go back down again, see the top tendril sticking. Even down to just a few RPM, that thing's still sticking there to the top. And now, there, it finally crossed over to the side again where it's sparking. And again, I rev it up. It won't let go of that side. Until it gets up to about 1,000 RPM there, it switched over. It stays that way right to full speed. Is taking on a strange greenish glow. We're not sure why, and we hope that we're not turning green too from this experiment. Check your skin, guys! Okay, I think we're signed off for that one. See you all next time.